Now, one of the most powerful politicians in the United States is in Belfast tonight. Nancy Pelosi is leading a senior delegation from the House of Representatives. Yesterday, she was in Dublin addressing politicians and attending a state dinner. This morning, she was on the Derry-Donegal border and she'll be visiting Stormont tomorrow. She had one message and it was delivered repeatedly.
We've learned so much at U2 concerts about what's going on in Ireland. I've said it before and I'll say it again. We must ensure that nothing happens in the Brexit discussions that imperils the Good Friday Accord, including but not limited to the seamless border between the Irish Republic and Northern Ireland. Let me be clear. If the Brexit deal undermines the Good Friday Accords, there would be no chance of a US-UK trade agreement.
I was on a bus here 30 years ago with the Speaker of the House, Tom Foley. The bus was stopped and British soldiers mounted the bus with full night vision and armament and they searched the bus. Here we are 30 years later with Speaker Pelosi and we accept the result of the Good Friday Agreement that eliminated the border and we walked back and forth. So at that time, you were searched. Today, your phone pings.
What it means to the world to have this example of reconciliation, really ending hundreds of years of conflict, recent thousands of deaths, and now a place where we're holding up traffic and they don't want us to do it very much anymore. So we're looking forward to a constructive conversation with friends here.
We all feel like family and close to each other. We're all concerned about the outcome. We all hope that Brexit will just be an aberration so we can get on with the business of getting the job done.
Nancy Pelosi in town there. Let's hear the thoughts of tonight's commentators, Newton Emerson and Deirdre Heenan. Welcome to you both. Let's start with that visit by the US delegation. Nancy Pelosi warning the government, no trade deal if there's a hard border here, Deirdre.
Well, she was quite clear in her message, and I think the Irish government will be delighted with the message that she delivered. And I think what was interesting was the message was picked up widely across the British media and does seem to have an impact on the thinking. She was quite clear in saying that anything that impacts on the Good Friday Agreement means there will not be a trade deal with the US. So the old idea of walking away from Europe and walking straight into a trade deal with the US is simply not going to happen. And in many ways, I think the Irish government were viewing it as a second backstop. So they have the backstop, and here, if you like, is a copper fastening of the backstop, a second one to say there will be no trade deal that impacts on the Good Friday Agreement.
And some unionists not terribly enamoured with the tone that she has struck. We know that Arlene Foster was at the dinner in Dublin last night, but I saw a statement from Jim Allister saying she's got it all wrong.
Yes, unionists are very unhappy about this, as is the European Research Group, who Pelosi actually went to Westminster to see. But they're really the only people who will be unhappy with this visit. Most MPs in Westminster, the British government, they'll be quietly delighted because this is another argument for a very soft Brexit for May's deal. And that's what they want to see. So it's more of the same kind of campaigning the Irish government has been able to arrange from senior European politicians. So it's not, although it is a very novel development on the American angle. And I think that's what's causing it to hit home in England. Yeah. It's very much more of the same as a diplomatic agenda.
Just briefly, you were at the dinner, you met her last night. I mean, Newton and I only dream of such access. On a personal level, what was she like?
Well, she's hugely impressive, and what an amount of energy. And I mean, she had standing ovations wherever she went. She spoke with passion, she spoke with knowledge about what was happening, but she was very clear. I thought it was interesting that when Obama made his intervention to say, well, if you want a trade deal, you'd be at the back of the queue, didn't really have a big impact on how people voted or what they thought. She clearly did, and people are beginning to say, well, actually, this isn't going to be as easy as we thought it was. And I think that her message resonated in a way that perhaps his didn't. So okay, I think she'd be very pleased with the visit.